What's happening, Nerd Squad? And welcome back.
We are back in studio with our first collab since how many months? December last year? Who knows?
That is far too long. The pandemic had us working from home, in studio, back at home again. But finally, nature is healing and the nerds, we are back in town.
We are back in action. And with the Disney Plus original series being released while we were at home working, we're meeting these new powerful characters in the Marvel Cinematic Universe one episode at a time.
And with Falcon taking over as Captain America and the introduction of Elijah Bradley, why not kick off the collab days counting down 10 of the most powerful black superheroes. I am excited.
And I'm Taylor McWaters.
And I'm Amanda McKnight.
Let's get counting. Kicking off the list at number 10, Storm. Aurora Monroe made her debut in Giant Size X-Men issue 1. She was recruited by Charles and joined the team to save other original students from Krakoa. She was appointed leader after several years of hard work. Storm has been called a witch before because her powers to control the air and the elements. I mean, fair enough, right? Things go up a notch in X-Men issue 135 during the Dark Phoenix saga. Sebastian Shaw calls her a weather witch, the old WW. Now, it's not just storms and earth that Aurora can control. Even in space, she can summon natural energy. And when it comes to handling weapons, Storm is also quite experienced with firearms. She's great at handling knives, she can handle the bow staff, and was trained by Wakanda's finest in sword fighting. Not too shabby.
Number 9, Luke Cage. Luke Cage is definitely one of the toughest guys around in comics. His skin is near unbreakable, which can be powerful, but also kind of a weakness at times if for some reason he needs a life-saving operation. Aside from his invulnerability, he also possesses super strength and durability. He's been able to hold back an airplane from taking off, and even been able to dole out enough force to weaken and eliminate Invisible Woman's force fields. While we also don't talk about it as often, he's also got pretty quick reflexes and can move fast when needed. He's caught a bullet before, which of course exploded against his skin.
Number 8, Isaiah Bradley. Played by Carl Lumbly in the Marvel Cinematic Universe and Falcon in the Winter Soldier, Isaiah Bradley makes his comic debut in Truth, Red, White, and Black issue 1. After the US Army lost the secrets of the Super Soldier Serum with Dr. Erskine, they still wanted to create more super soldiers. So Colonel Walker Price and Dr. Wilfred Nagel took 300 soldiers, including Isaiah, by force and used them as subjects. It was awful. They had sent the soldiers' family members invalid letters stating that they were no longer alive. It was horrible. Only a handful ended up surviving this process, and they went on to be this covert black ops team. Now, after a few missions, Isaiah was the last soldier left. Issue 5 opens up with Isaiah suited up in the stars and stripes. The new Captain America was born using a triangular shield that he decorated with the Double V campaign eagle crest. The German soldiers thought that the Americans were bombing them because they didn't see any planes, but really it was Isaiah Bradley, just a one-man army. He was laying TNT down all over, but it wasn't easy for him. It wasn't like this action cinematic thing. He was crying while he was doing this the entire time. He felt awful for what he had to do. He thought of his love, Faith, and their daughter, Sarah. He tried to save everybody held at the camp, and he was said to not have survived afterwards. In the 6th issue of Truth, Red, White, and Black, it cuts back and forth between present-day Steve Rogers interrogating Merritt on the past and what happened, and that's when he found out about the secret history of the Black Captain America for the first time.
Number 7, Black Panther. Black Panther verse 616 has become one of the most iconic heroes out there since he joined the MCU and was played by the late and great Chadwick Boseman. May he rest in power. Wakanda forever, Chadwick. Black Panther is currently a member of the Avengers and funds the superhero team. He comes with many different powers, skills, and resources. He has all of Wakanda's wealth and resources at his disposal as their ruler, can call in diplomatic favors if needed, and has been granted superpowers through the heart-shaped herb, which he uses to help others and protect the planet Earth as one of their mightiest heroes. Black Panther also works amazingly hard to run the nation of Wakanda and to lead the Avengers, as we saw when we got a glimpse into his morning routine and daily schedule in Avengers issue 45 from the current 2018 run. I'm telling you, his morning routine puts mine to shame, and I feel like I work hard. I do not, compared to Black Panther.
Number 6, Ultimate Nick Fury. When he entered the Ultimates and Marvel Team-Up issue 5, Nick Fury would soon take over as Director of S.H.I.E.L.D. And his first plan was to bring back the Super Soldier program, which actually resulted in the creation of said Ultimates. Now, his origins are pretty intense before all this stuff too. He fought for the United States in World War II and was used as a test subject for Project Rebirth. So when he was injected with his new serum, it gave him super strength, and in turn, he freed himself and other prisoners and got the hell out of Dodge. Now now he's got quite the power behind those punches. He's disease resistant and he has enhanced senses. The whole super soldier package, basically. Now, Samuel L. Jackson not only brought this character to life in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, but when creator Mark Miller began writing the Ultimates back in the early 2000s, Samuel L. Jackson was one of his favorite actors, as he should be, so he made Ultimate Nick Fury resemble him. Jackson himself was a comic book fan, so when he saw this, he asked his agents, begged them really, to make this role a reality on the big screen. Now, cut to 11 movies later, it's safe to say this is our Nick Fury.
Number 5, Nubia. Nubia is the sister of Diana, who had a complex past in terms of her comic book history. In the Prime Earth continuity, she was an Amazonian who spent a long time in captivity, being held by a man who was very unkind to her and brutally mistreated Nubia. And that's putting it lightly because YouTube. Eventually, Nubia came to Themyscira and enjoyed her life there, living free. She would go on in the main continuity to become the new queen after Hippolyta sought out a new Wonder Woman, a warrior who was the most brave of all of her warriors. Her challenge to those who wished to qualify was to look in a bin where the head of Medusa the Gorgon was. Nubia was the only one brave enough to actually look, but instead, when she did, she found a crown. Hippolyta planned to go out into the world of man, and instead of becoming Wonder Woman, Nubia became the new queen instead. Wow, I love it. Like all Amazons, Nubia receives powers of strength, wisdom, and immortality, just from her heritage. Nubia is also known for being a very gifted and skilled warrior and combatant with an indomitable will.
Number 4, Falcon. Superheroes usually don't have an easy childhood. Either they're bullied off the bat, or they're born with advanced abilities that make them an outcast, or something traumatic happens with their parents. But in the case of Sam Wilson, he grew up in a tough neighborhood in Harlem. His father, Paul, was a minister and tragically met his fate one night after trying to stop a fight between two gangs. Sam was only 9 years old when this happened, and soon after, his mother, Darlene, was attacked by a mugger and sadly didn't make it. She passed away protecting her children. Cut 2 years later, as an adult, Sam is now taking over the mantle of Captain America in Volume 7, Issue 25, back in 2014, and recently in Marvel Studios' Falcon and the Winter Soldier, he did the same. But before he got the shield from Cap, Sam watched the skies as Falcon, even having a trusty little sidekick of his own, Redwing. In Captain America, Issue 170, Sam received a harness that allowed him to fly from Black Panther. I'm so excited to see more of Anthony Mackie as Captain America. He absolutely killed it in the show. If you haven't watched it, just honestly like this video and then turn it off and then go watch it. But definitely like it first.
And friends, before we move on to the next spot, if you are loving this list and you want more lists like it, which honestly, I want to do more lists like this for you, so please do this. Make sure you hit that like, hit that subscribe, comment. Really, it does let us know you love this and you want more stuff like this. And I have a lot of black superheroes I want to talk about. I don't know about you, Taylor, but I got a lot. Yeah, Taylor also has a lot, so yeah. Number 3, Green Lantern. Green Lantern Joe Malene is definitely one of my favorite new superheroes, and possibly one of my favorite superheroes now of all time, depending on how it all ends up going, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna go great. With Far Sector, she stole my heart though, for sure. Lantern Malene is introduced to us as being the Green Lantern of a far out sector. So far out, in fact, that she isn't even sure it has a number. Hence why we just refer to it as the Far Sector. So if you're wondering what number it is, the Far Sector. Joe's ring is special in the fact that it doesn't need a battery to operate. It can self-charge, but the only problem is that it takes time to recover its battery stores. While initially this is considered to be a weaker kind of ring among the Green Lantern Corps, it also promises to be one that, when mastered, could be considered one of the most powerful Green Lantern rings ever. In other words, it's just challenging to use, but once you figure it out, you're looking at insane power levels. It's like when you play Smash Bros. Or League of Legends and you choose a really complicated character to play. So far, we've seen Joe manage to pull off some pretty impressive feats with her ring, and even go to places that, as a human, she shouldn't be able to traverse, like the City Network.
Number 2, Spawn. Coming from Image Comics, created by Todd McFarlane back in the early 90s, Spawn, aka Albert Francis Simmons, was born in Detroit, Michigan. He was one of three brothers, and by the time he was an adult, Albert reached the rank of Lieutenant Colonel. Joining the United States Secret Service, Simmons was later recruited by director Jason Wynn into this top secret covert ops division called the US Security Group. So he was already killing it before the Spawn Devil stuff, but let's talk about that stuff now. Simmons and said director were getting off on the wrong foot, and Simmons was about to resign until he was seemingly killed during a mission in Botswana. Director Wynn actually sent the order. Classic. So Simmons ended up being sent to hell because all the assassin stabby stuff, he ended up making a deal with the devil in order to get out, to become a hellspawn in order to see his wife Wanda one more time. He can alter his destiny at will. He can teleport, control nature, and can sense misery in others, including you, Paramore. I was 3 when the Spawn movie came out. I'm not gonna lie, it scared the out of me more than anything. I was way too young to figure out what was going on. I just saw fire and like an angry mask and I was like, I'm out of here. I'm gonna have nightmares for weeks. But now I'd love a Spawn movie. Let's bring Spawn back, like ASAP. Let's get a Spawn show.
Number 1, Blue Marvel. Someone who does not get enough love but definitely deserves it is Blue Marvel. Blue Marvel is immensely powerful and got his powers from an accident that happened during the testing of a reactor that could have helped to supply unlimited clean energy to planet Earth. Brashear was one of the scientists who had been working towards this astounding discovery and invented and ended up caught in the crossfire when the reactor unexpectedly exploded. Due to exposure, he was given amazing antimatter based powers that basically turned him into a Superman level superpowered being. Blue Marvel can emit energy blasts, can fly, is basically invulnerable, possesses cosmic awareness, and can manipulate matter at a molecular level. Oh, and he also just happens to be a genius.
Guys, who is your favorite of the heroes that we've listed here today?
Which hero do you think is the most powerful?
Which black superhero would you like to see more of in the spotlight and get their own ongoing series? Let us know all your thoughts in the comments down below.
Number 10, Misty Knight. Especially when you consider Misty Knight doesn't really have supernatural or sci-fi based superpowers to back her up, she's pretty impressive. Misty is a detective who started out working on the NYPD. She ended up losing her arm in an explosion and, due to her heroic efforts, caught the attention of genius billionaire Tony Stark, aka Iron Man, who made her a bionic replacement. But her arm isn't even the most impressive thing about her, not even close. Aside from her mad detective skills, she is also an amazingly skilled fighter. Misty has even studied with some of the best martial artists in the world of Marvel. She has trained with both Iron Fist and Shang-Chi, and is best friends with another extremely skilled fighter and martial artist, Colleen Wing. The two often team up together and have been known as the Daughters of the Dragon. So if you need some Colleen Wing and Misty Knight team ups in your life, that is a comic you should check out. Number 9, Amanda Waller. Amanda Waller might not be as powerful or as heroic as some of the others listed here, but she definitely does her best to keep the world safe, in her own way. And she's not someone you should underestimate when it comes to her power levels. You've been warned. Amanda Waller is often known as the creator and overall commander of Task Force X, aka the Suicide Squad. When it comes to this team of often villainous misfits, she is the one that calls the shots and also knows how to coax her team members into doing what she wants and what she needs to get done. Amanda Waller has also been known as a skilled fighter and a tactician herself back in the day, but it's truly her influence that makes her so powerful and so scary. And friends, if you are loving this list and you want even more lists like it, or perhaps a part 3, please, 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 then be sure to let us know by giving this video a thumbs up. Number 8, Spider-Man. Miles Morales is Spider-Man. I personally am ready for the day that we actually get to see what happened in Ultimates happen in the main continuity, where Peter passes on the mantle of being Spidey to Miles, who takes over as the main continuity Spider-Man in 616, like full time. Can we please have that happen at some point, because I am ready for it. Miles is an interesting Spider-Man as well, having powers that also just make him more versatile and at times even more powerful than Peter Parker's Spider-Man. He's less experienced, so he doesn't have the experience, but his powers are pretty crazy. He has camouflage powers that allow him to blend in with his surroundings, becoming basically invisible to those around him. He also has his Venom Blast powers, which are similar to Jessica Drew's, aka Spider-Woman's abilities, allowing him to shock his opponents, and so much more. Number 7, Black Panther. While we may have already talked about T'Challa on part 1 of this list, there was another hero who has also worn this mantle that I think is powerful enough to make our cut here on part 2. That would be none other than the sister of T'Challa, Shuri. Shuri actually wanted a chance at being Black Panther ever since she was little, and even trained with T'Challa to make sure her fighting prowess was where it needed to be, should she ever be called on. Like T'Challa, Shuri is is a part of the royal family and the Panther tribe, so she also has many of the skills that her brother possesses. She also is known for her gifted intellect, being at a genius level when it comes to her smarts, like T'Challa. When he ended up in a coma, it was Shuri's turn to prove herself, and for a time in the comics, she was known as not only the Queen of Wakanda, but also their Black Panther as well. Number 6. Static. Static is probably the most popular character to have come out of Milestone Comics, and for good reason. Static is Virgil Hawkins, a teen superhero who is known as one of the Bang Babies. He got his powers during an event called the Big Bang. Hence, Bang Babies. In issue 1 of the newest revitalized Milestone series, Static Season 1, this event was modernized and turned into a protest as opposed to the original event, which was kind of more of like a gang war. The experimental gas that was used on protesters resulted in many dying and granted powers to those who managed to survive. Virgil is not just a superhero for his powers, though. He's also known for his genius-level intellect. But his powers also are pretty impressive, allowing him to blast people with electroshocks, but he can also absorb energy, use electricity to shield himself and others, and use it to take control of metal or technology. Pretty neat. Those are some versatile powers. Number 5. Cyborg. Cyborg quickly became one of the most important characters in the DC Extended Universe when Zack Snyder's cut of Justice League was released. In terms of the films in that universe, it was there that Cyborg, played by Ray Fisher, was lifted up and established as probably one of the most powerful members of the League in general. When it comes to hacking, programming, and access to the unseen digital spaces online, there is no one better than Cyborg, and this gives him a lot of power. We also see his capabilities touched upon on the smaller screen when it comes to the character, as portrayed by Jovane Waite in the television series Doom Patrol. Honestly, it was seeing all that Cyborg had to deal with and was capable of in Doom Patrol that made me so interested in reading more Cyborg-centric stories in the comics. Vic Stone is just such a powerful and brave hero overall, and for that, he definitely deserves respect. I love Cyborg. I'm sorry I left you off part one, Cyborg. There's too many amazing heroes. They're all so good. I just want to have a list where I can put like a bunch at number one, because there's so many of these people that I think deserve the number one spot as well. How about a top number one list? Top 10 number ones. Number 4, Green Lantern. John Stewart has some of the strongest willpower of all of the Green Lanterns we've come to know. He has used this willpower to create all sorts of constructs and achieve all sorts of ridiculous but really important accomplishments. At one point, he uses his power to hold all of the Earth together when it threatens to fall apart. And remember when he became responsible for kind of like the death of a solar system? Well, at one point, John attempts to actually redeem himself through recreating said solar system, using only the powers of Green Lantern and his willpower. Creating an entire solar system is pretty nuts. So, yeah. Number 3, Spectrum. Also known as Captain Marvel. In fact, Monica Rambeau was Captain Marvel before Carol was. Monica, in her Captain Marvel persona, would even go on to lead the Avengers for a very brief time. Later, she would give the mantle of Captain Marvel when Mar-Vell's son surfaced and wanted to use it. Monica would go on to take up the mantle of Photon, then Pulsar, before finally settling on Spectrum. Her powers are immensely powerful and allow her to shift into any form of energy. She received them after attempting to apprehend a criminal on the seas and being exposed to radiation from one of their inventions. Monica used to work as a lieutenant for the New Orleans Harbor Patrol before becoming a full-fledged superhero and leaving New Orleans for New York in hopes that someone there could help her get a better handle on her new powers. Which it turns out people were able to do, so it all worked out. Yay! Now she's crazy powerful. She's like really, really powerful. Number 2, Icon. When it comes to Milestone superheroes, probably one of the most powerful of all is Icon. Icon is basically Milestone's Superman, and the two characters have even fought before, proving that the two are pretty much equals when it comes to their power levels. Augustus Freeman is Icon, an alien from another world who adopted the appearance of the first person seen by his escape pod as part of its technology, allowing him to better blend in. Due to the time period when he arrived, he crash-landed on a plantation and was approached by a black woman who lived there and was forced to work against her will in the fields. She raised Augustus, and through the years and decades, he would live on reinventing himself every so often and claiming to be the son of the Augustus Freeman who came before him. Who was really, of course, just him. Number 1. Nova. Nova is Anwen Bacane, a hero who comes from an alternate reality, the reality of New Xandar, known as Earth 94241. Her mother, Eve, was a member of the Nova Corps, and Anwen would go on to become the hero Nova following in her mother's footsteps, also becoming a member of the Corps when Eve actually returned, as the ranks were so low and she needed recruits. She ended up proving to be more powerful than you might think, and would even defeat Thanos, who appeared to be working alongside the Nova Corps, but later revealed himself to be a traitor. He killed Anwen's mother, Eve, trapping her soul in the Soul Stone. But in the end, Anwen would get him back when she agreed to give him the Reality Stone, but had actually given him the newly created Death Stone. He had affixed the newly received stone to his gauntlet without really knowing, and as such was defeated by it. Nova's powers are all granted to her by equipment, including her Nova suit, or of course Nova Star, and the Infinity Gauntlet, which she wields. So yeah, she might not seem that powerful, and she is an alternate reality superhero who is only in like a few issues, but she does have an Infinity Gauntlet, which is pretty OP, so thought she might be a fun one to let you know about, or remind you about, if you knew about her before.
Number 10. Black Panther. With a Black Panther movie on the way, comic fans everywhere have T'Challa on the brain. He was pretty revolutionary in comics though. Not only was he the first mainstream black superhero, but he actually got his name before the Black Panther Party got theirs. So he was the OG. T'Challa is a really sick hero, both as the powerful and talented chief of the Wakandas, and fighting crime with the help of his vibranium suit. Definitely the coolest looking hero in the MCU, and his African origins were quite unique in comics for the time. Number 9. Riri Williams. Riri definitely has her haters, but that doesn't stop her from being an awesome character. Riri came onto the scene in some pretty turbulent times, having essentially replaced one of the most popular Marvel heroes ever, Tony Stark. And the fact that she was a black woman made it even harder for some fans to accept her. However, she's really impressive. She's super smart, incredibly creative, and did I mention that she built a frickin' Iron Man suit in her dorm room at age 15? Yeah, she clearly knows her stuff. So to any Riri haters out there, give her a chance. It's not like Tony was gone forever, and she definitely adds a new dimension to the comics. Number 8. Blade. Blade might be pushing the definition of superhero, but I won't be doing a top 10 black anti-heroes list, so he's gotta be on here. Blade is a quasi-vampire who goes around and hunts down vamps, using a plethora of wicked weapons, including his signature double-edged sword. His comics have some of the best hack and slash action out there. Now, the early Blade comics are not the most racially sensitive. He was kind of a walking stereotype in looks and the things he says. He was even trained by a black jazz trumpeter. Pretty cliche. I mean, it's not as bad as this, but it isn't great. That said, he was totally awesome, and the comics do get better with this, so I'll take a bit of early stereotyping to get a badass protagonist in the end. I say that like it's up to me. Number 7. Black Lightning. Jefferson Pierce grew up in the slums of Metropolis, living with his mother after his father was killed. While they had the power of electrokinesis, he was rather reluctant to use it in heroics, only being convinced to become Black Lightning when he realized the cops just weren't doing their jobs well enough. In the comics, he kept his identity hidden by hamming up 70s black stereotypes while in character, putting on an afro and talking all jive. But he's actually a really deep and interesting character with varied interests, including a love of poetry. He's also an awesome athlete, so he's physically very fit, and he can even enhance his own strength and durability with his powers. Not too shabby. Number 6. Steel. Oh boy. Steel. So John Henry Irons, and of course his last name was Irons, was a weapons engineer whose life was saved by Superman. In an attempt to make his life worthwhile, Irons decided to help fight Doomsday with a sledgehammer. Needless to say, it didn't work, but he later built an awesome power suit and became one of the four Supermen while the main man was assumed dead. He went by Man of Steel, which was later shortened to Steel, and he could throw down. And then he was totally screwed over when they decided to make a film about him starring none other than Shaquille O'Freakin' Neal. Ugh. Number 5. Spider-Man, Miles Morales. Miles Morales is a Spider-Man from an alternate universe who took on the role after Peter's death. He eventually ended up on Earth 616 following the destruction of Battle World and has been a pretty popular version of the web-slinger ever since. What's really cool about him is he brings all new powers to the table. He, unlike Peter, can essentially turn invisible by camouflaging against the background. Plus, he can use bioelectrokinesis, which lets him electrocute people or deactivate technology with venom blasts using the energy of his body. So sick! As with any superhero semi-replacement, he was met with some backlash, but he's since found a pretty nice spot on the Marvel roster. Number 4. John Stewart. No, not that John Stewart, the Green Lantern one. John Stewart was the fourth Green Lantern from Earth, having been brought on when Guy Gardner was injured. Stewart's race was pushed to the forefront in his very first mission when he was sent to protect a racist politician. While he initially seemed to shirk his duties out of hate for the racist, it was revealed that he saw through the politician's ruse. Turns out the jerk was trying to fake an assassination attempt from an African-American for political gain. Classy. John ended up being a pretty great lantern and quite the fan favorite. He's quite a bit more serious than other lanterns since he's a military veteran, which I really like. Plus, as the master builder, his constructs are some of the most impressive out there. He might not be the most powerful of Earth's lanterns, but damn is he interesting. Number 3. Luke Cage. Luke Cage, unfortunately known as Power Man for a time, has seen an awful lot of screen time recently with the new Marvel shows on Netflix. With his super strength and bulletproof skin, he kicked all kinds of bad guy butt. Now, as a black man in the 70s, race has always been a significant factor in Cage's heroics. It's no coincidence that this proud black man actually derives his power from his skin, and he's been rather inspirational to people of color over the years. Now, with his Netflix show drawing some weird criticism for having too many black people, it seems like the fight is just beginning for Cage. Number 2. Spawn. I know, he's probably more of an anti-hero like Blade, but I love anti-heroes and Spawn is awesome, and his skin color was actually a pretty big part of his character. If you're unfamiliar, Al Simmons became Spawn when he died and made a deal with Malebolgia to go back to Earth in a ballin' costume, and he killed criminals. A lot. Spawn was played by Michael Jai White in the 97 movie, making him the first African-American to play a major superhero on film. Spawn was actually so proud of his heritage that when given a chance to be returned to a human body, he refused because the body was white. Number 1. Storm. Storm is one of the most popular X-Men of all time, and she's been involved in quite a few stories about racism. With the X-Men comics being so metaphorically entrenched in the civil rights movement, the black female star of the comics was in the limelight a fair bit. She was super iconic as one of the few black members of the X-Men, and really one of the few black superheroes for some time. Plus, she wasn't just a token black character, she was one of the most powerful X-Men. She had amazing abilities, plus she was the head of Xavier's school, and even led the X-Men for quite some time. Storm was basically the epitome of the minority as a black female mutant, and it really resonated with a huge portion of the US and the world.